Hello, I am Elodie van de Notte. I am working as a project leader in pharmacology in HTS Pharma Company. I would like to thank you for attending this meeting, for registering to attend this webinar on how to create physiologically relevant 3D in vitro models using biomimesis hydroscaffold. So, a few words first about HTS Pharma Company. It was founded in 2014. It is now counting 13 employees, including 5 PhDs. Our offices and labs are located in the north of France, in Lille, in the building that you can see on this picture. Historically, we are providing services for safety and efficacy assays in high content analysis and high content screening, meaning high throughput imaging, using 2D and 3D circuitry systems. Our customers are from the cosmetic, pharmaceutical, and nutraceutical industries. Our company and our leader, Nathalie Maubon, have won awards, Innovation Prize in 2015, Lab Startup Village winner in 2019, Jury's Choice Awards in 2019 by StartWest. And last year, we were selected as a Deep Tech Pioneer by Hello Tomorrow Global Summit. In 2017, HTS Pharma acquired Biomimesis Patent, an innovative in vivo mimicking 3D cell culture technology. That's why now HTS Pharma is concentrating all of its R&D efforts to create a full range of biomimesis cell culture systems to answer drug discovery needs for various tissues or organs and different therapeutic areas. HTS Pharma owns two biosafety level 2 cell culture labs, a chemistry lab for biomimesis R&D and manufacturing, cell handling and automated imaging devices. We have one Image Express Micro XLS for molecular devices in standalone. We also have two Cyclone in standalone. And on our platform called HAPIX, we have two Image Express Micro Confocal imaging system for molecular devices, so integrated on a complete robotic platform for high content screening, as well as a UV irradiation system. So this is HAPIX on the picture, so our platform. Nowadays, still many cultures are performed in 2D. I mean, cells are grown on plastic dishes. But we now know that, it is well known that there are dedifferentiation issues, that the structures are not relevant in such systems. At least it is not physiological and it does not mimic in vivo situation where several cell types are embedded within the extracellular matrix, forming complex 3D structures being vascularized with blood vessels. Our objective with biomimesis is to be close to reality because we know that in biomimesis we can culture several cell types embedded in a physiological ACM mimicking the native extracellular matrix. There is a need to reproduce in vivo situation using 3D cell cultures with different cell types and a relevant microenvironment as a physiological extracellular matrix to develop alternative, predictive, in fact, in vitro cellular models. Indeed, the extracellular matrix plays important roles in the biology and the physiology. It impacts cell anchorage and migration. It is important in cell-cell communication because it is a reservoir for signaling cues like growth factors, for example. The extracellular matrix also interacts directly with the cells through different receptors and through biomechanical force. And in this frame, it impacts cell behavior its differentiation, its proliferation. And also importantly, the matrix is can be modulated in health and disease. Even if there are differences in the composition of the extracellular matrix between the different organs, they are common components. First, structural elements with glycosaminoglycans, among them hyaluronic acid and also proteoglycans, and structural proteins, the different types of collagen, elastin as an example. Apart from structural elements, we can also find adhesion proteins in the ECM, like fibronectin or laminins. The composition varies from one organ to another, but also the stiffness of the matrix is different from one organ to another. For example, the brain is one of the smoothest organ in the body. Therefore, it does not really make sense to cultivate them in plastics, on plasticware, because then the stiffness is even higher than that of the bone. And it's the same is true for other organs with intermediate stiffnesses, as measured by the elastic modulus in Pascal. So the stiffness is critical to generate the adequate ECM impact on cells and to obtain representative cell responses. And unlike other 3D cell culture systems, biomimesis matrix stiffness can be adjusted over a large range to mimic, in fact, the cellular microenvironment of any tissue or organ, even in pathological conditions, for example, in fibrosis. Within the matrix, hyaluronic acid plays an important role, for example, in the structure of the tissue because it absorbs lots of water. It binds to growth factors and proteoglycans and other chemical cues. And it impacts cell matrix interactions because there are different hyaluronic acid receptors at the surface of the cells, inducing, in fact, biological effects through different signaling pathways. What is biomimesis? So chemically, it is a mix of hyaluronic acid grafted with adhesion proteins, together with collagens that are finally cross-linked using a peptidic cross-linker called ADH. If you mix these components, you would get a hydrogel, but this hydrogel would be unadapted to cell culture because it degrades quickly. And that is also why there are not so many systems based on hyaluronic acid on the market. But thanks to a patented process, we are able to get a long-term hydroscaffold, biomimesis, which is an interpenetrated network of hyaluronic acid and collagens. This hydroscaffold has a stiffness between 100 and 15 kilopascal. We can adjust it, thanks also to this process, with a porosity range between 100 and 200 micrometer. Biomimesis is therefore made of native ECM components, and the related process makes this matrix stable a long time, with a stiffness and a composition that can be adjusted to mimic organ or diseased extracellular matrix microenvironments. How does biomimesis look like under scanning electron microscopy? So you can see on this SEM picture that biomimesis is porous. So the cells are diffusing within the matrix. And from this picture, you can see in detail the hyaluronic sheets in gray and the collagen in brown, interlaced with hyaluronic acid. What about the cellularized organ, so the native ECM? you see that the structure, the ultrastructure, is really similar with what is observed in biomimesis. So biomimesis is porous, and it mimics the in vivo extracellular matrix. Biomimesis, therefore, can reproduce the in vivo environment as a unique hydroscaffold that mimics the extracellular matrix. Biomimesis is the only system reproducing the stiffness naturally observed in the various healthy or pathological tissues or organs. Interestingly, biomimesis is a long-term matrix, so you can keep the cells for a long time because it provides anchor to cells for better cell longevity, up to several months. And biomimesis, being composed of purified and synthetic well-controlled components, it allows batch-to-batch consistency, so no surprise from one batch to another. Biomimesis fills the gap between the 3D cell culture systems on the market at the moment and in vivo for higher predictability of your models by reproducing the ECM and the structures. I will now detail, in fact, a bit the features, the advantages of using biomimesis for your cell culture. First, let's have a look at cell differentiation and longevity. With human white pre-adipocytes that are grown in biomimesis adipose tissue, we see that they effectively create cellular grapes that are accumulating neutral lipids, as seen by adiporet staining in green. The lipid vesicles that are forming within the adipocytes express perilipin in green here, confirming the maturation of these vesicles. And the expression of GLUT4 is increased a long time. So you can keep, you see the cells at least for 28 days in culture with an increase in the expression of GLUT4. If you need more information, we'll have a next webinar just about this subject and this matrix, biomimesis adipose tissue, and you can find more information in the publication from 2017. So the maturation of human white pre-adipocytes in biomimesis is confirmed by the development of adipocyte clusters that accumulate lipids in mature vesicles, and cells can be kept at least for 28 days. What about the differentiation of iPSCs? And in particular, we will have a focus on hepatocyte cell cultures. In 2D, the hepatocytes, even primary hepatocytes, are not fully functional with CYP activities or low CYP activities. Difficulty also to cultivate all liver cell types, and the architecture is not relevant at all. By differentiating iPSCs in the biomimesis liver, we managed to get complete organoids counting not only hepatocytes, as seen with the albumin staining, but also stellate cells, cholangiocytes, and sinusoidal endothelial cells. The phalloidin staining, so actin staining on the right, and let's look at the little video. The staining shows that there is in fact an architecture within these organoids. The CYP activities are also present, are also functional. Here the example of CYP3A4 with the metabolism of testosterone. So in biomimesis liver, we managed to get mature, functional, and architectured liver organoids from human-induced pluripotent stem cells. The differentiation is great, but also the tissue functionality and also the pathological conditions. For example, steatosis, meaning the accumulation of lipids within hepatocytes could be induced by treatment with ethanol, increasing concentration of ethanol in these a PSCD with liver organoids. The nitrate staining shows this increase in accumulation of lipids, and the alpha smooth muscle actin in parallel was showing the activation of stellate cells upon treatment with ethanol. Interestingly, we know that the cells are biomimesis liver matrix, but they are able to modulate the matrix itself by producing here type 1 collagen, as observed in blue with biphoton microscopy. So the matrix is plastic, is versatile. So iPSCs derived liver organoids that were grown in biomimesis are functional, and they provide a valuable in vitro model for hepatic toxicity studies, steatosis studies. Cultivating cells in biomimesis also makes the cellular models more predictive. I will show you by two examples. The first one, the study of anti-cancer drug efficacy to kill cancer cells. We took the drug 5-fluorouracil, and we checked the cell viability by a live dead assay. The EC50 curve here in blue for the 2D culture shows a low EC50 value, so a low concentration is able to kill the cells. But if we extrapolate the in vivo curve here in red, see that the response is really far from the in vivo situation. The results obtained in 2D do not correlate with those observed in vivo. But with biomimesis, you obtain this EC50 curve, and showing that biomimesis offers a better correlation with in vivo data regarding the drug efficacy. We did not only check the drug efficacy, but also drug safety by focusing on hepatic steatosis, which means the accumulation of neutral lipids in hepatocytes, induced here with bimacetic drugs. We compared the in vivo data, meaning in clinics, and the in vitro responses of cells of hepatocytes in 3D within Utrala attachment plate and biomimesis. So in vivo, we made a literature search about the effects of this mycetic drug after chronic administration in human. And in vitro, we quantified the accumulation of vinylhead, the quantification of lipid accumulation in orange here, in hepatocytes, in ULA plates, or in biomimesis liver plates. In vivo, it is known that drug 1, 2, 3, and 8 might induce steatosis, either having no effect, a low effect, or a moderate effect. In vitro, with an acute treatment, we would exclude almost all of these molecules that are on the market. So drugs 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8, because they have they had a really high impact on the hepatocyte, a high accumulation of lipids was observed. On the contrary, with biomimesis, we could in fact predict the no or low effect of drugs, or moderate effect of drug 1 and 2, and therefore the biomimesis offers better correlation with in vivo data regarding drug safety. The viability and the accumulation observed was much closer to what is observed in humans. What about other 3D cell culture systems, like ultra-low attachment plates or spheroid plates that force, in fact, cells to grow as a spheroid? We know that there is no relevant microenvironment in such systems, so you cannot study cell ECM interactions, and the mechanical stress is not applied on cells, so the stiffness is not taken into account. On matrigel or other hydrogel systems, the microenvironment is not physiological or non-human. The stiffness, again, even if sometimes it is said that it can be adjusted, it cannot be adjusted on the whole range that is seen in vivo. There are some batch-to-batch reproducibility, in particular for matrix, and you cannot fully automate the process, and the long-term culture might also be a problem. In fact, the gold standard for the ECM would be to use decellularized organ, because they are physiological and they reproduce, I mean, they are the microenvironment of the cells, but this is labor intensive, so it is expensive, technically difficult. Of course, you do not have reproducibility from one experiment to another, and you cannot fully automate the process. But with biomimesis, you are able to use a physiological microenvironment with an organ-specific composition and stiffness. So the matrix is relevant. You can look at cell-cell interactions, cell-ECM interactions. The stiffness can be taken into account. There is a high batch-to-batch reproducibility, and you can fully automate the process. Therefore, biomimesis associates the behavior of a cell scaffold and of a hydrogel for a proper matrix architecture, a proper cellular organization, cell-cell and cell matrix interactions. Biomimesis being an organ-specific ECM, we have developed different products: biomimesis adipose tissue, biomimesis liver, the last one biomimesis brain. And also by pathology, we now have biomimesis oncology, so the generic matrix enriched in collagen 1. Here are the different products that you can get with their different compositions and the different in vivo-like elastic moduli. Biomimesis is ready to use because you get lyophilized hydroscaffold that is cast in well plates, 96 or 384 well plates. The plates are in bags, vacuum sealed bags, and the matrix is stable for at least 1 year if stored in the fridge. It is ready to use, so you just need to perform the cell seeding. No preparation is required. You work at room temperature. You just seed the suspension on the middle of the hydroscaffold, and the cell will diffuse within the matrix. I will show you a short video afterwards. The matrix is lyophilized, so it is white when you receive it, but as soon as you put medium on, the matrix becomes translucent. Let's look at this quick video. So we have lots of tutorials on our website on how to use biomimesis plates. Here we would just have a look with how to seed cells with a classical monopipette. So you prepare your cell suspension. You, in fact, just need to put the drop of cells in the middle of the hydroscaffold, and the cells will diffuse within the pores of the matrix. So this is, as I said, ready to use. Just open the plastic bag, you take the plate, and you seed your cells. The detail of the well view shows that effectively, when you put the cell suspension, in fact, the matrix becomes translucent, and therefore the matrix is adapted to microscopy and other techniques. I will show you this in detail now. Biomimesis is effectively adapted to different to classical downstream applications. Since it is translucent, it is adapted to microscopy and spectroscopic plate readers for classical OD, fluorescence, and luminescence readings. Given that it is highly porous. It is adapted for PCRs, Western blot, and ELISA assays. It is biodegradable. In fact, we can provide you with a specific protocol to degrade the matrix and to get finally live cells for example, flow cytometry. Last but not least, the matrix is solid, so it is compatible for histological techniques and also in vivo implantation, in vivo grafting. As you can see from this picture, you can take the matrix with the cells and in fact take it and put it somewhere else. It's not a problem. And for the grafting, in fact, the grafting success was really high with lower number of cells. So biomimesis is compatible with mainstream analytical technologies. So you just use it as you would do with other systems. Biomimesis product list shows you that we can provide the matrix in transparent or black plates, with different formats like 24 hydroscaffolds in a 96-well plate or complete plates. And we can also provide you with biomimesis, custom biomimesis, by finally doing the composition that you are requiring using different ECM components with a specific elastic modulus. And also in specific vessel format on demand, like 6-well plates, 24-well plates, and so on, with custom plate format, but also custom filling, either all the wells on some of them, like here. As a conclusion, so biomimesis is able to reproduce the in vivo environment. It is the unique hydroscaffold reproducing the ECM. It is the only system that can reproduce the full range of stiffnesses naturally observed in various healthy or pathological tissues and organs. Biomimesis is a long-term matrix providing anchor to cells for better cell longevity up to several months. And since biomimesis is composed of purified and synthetic well-controlled components, it allows great batch-to-batch consistency. So biomimesis is a ready-to-use and organ or tissue-specific 3D cell culture system that allows a higher predictability of your in vitro models. This year, we will make different webinars. We will propose different webinars about biomimesis. Next month, about, in particular, biomimesis liver. In April, biomimesis adipose tissue. In May, biomimesis brain. In September, biomimesis oncology. Stay tuned. We will keep you informed about these next webinars. So I would like to thank you for your attention. I am now waiting for your questions together with Ziad Sougir, the inventor, the chemist inventor of biomimesis hydroscaffold. If you need more information, please feel free to contact us at hello@biomimesis.com or to contact our sales department, Sandrine Poncet or Sandrine Villouin, with these email addresses or phone numbers.